वेलकम मिस्टर टी ए शेखर, और इनके बारे में क्या कहें, इज द फिनोमिनल टैलेंट एंड ही हैज बीन वर्किंग विद द मुंबई इंडियंस टीम. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी वुड लाइक टू कांग्रेचुलेट हिम सर, थैंक यू सो मच दैट यू आर हियर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू नो फ्रॉम यू दैट व्हाट डू यू थिंक अबाउट दिस इनिशिएटिव एट द 26 स्टेट्स, वी हैव लॉट्स ऑफ टैलेंट ओवर हियर, एंड हाउ कुड यू सी दिस इनिशिएटिव एज पर द टैलेंट हंट.
Yeah, India is a huge country, and then a lot of talent is around India, and then you can see a lot of people are knocking at the doors of a lot of age group tournaments, and then state, and then zone, and then maybe they go up to India. I think it's a very good initiative to tap the talent from the grassroots level, and the best guys will be coached by some of the best coaches in the country are here. And it's a good opportunity for them to showcase their skill to the coaches. And then the Leap Academy, which where I'm involved, is a very good setup. So I come there regularly, and then Raghuram Bhatt, the ex-Indian spinner, is also there. Kiran More, we come here regularly. So it's a good opportunity, because when I started playing, I didn't have any formal coaching. Nobody even taught me how to hold the ball, what to do, what not to do. But today, a place like this, you learn what to do, what not to do. I would say, if you learn the don'ts, that is better than the do's, because so you'll do less mistakes, so you will progress in your career. It's an excellent initiative. Whoever has started it, I congratulate them to continue this. So keep hunting talent, and then try to put them up to various academies, and then they. See, in cricket, you can make a career out of it. Today, you have a lot of opportunities. You can make a career. You can get a good job. You can make some good money, because everyone wants money. Everybody wants to have a living. So this game, it gives you a good living and a good career. And one more thing is that sports is something which will not allow you to get into bad habits. Still, a lot of sportsmen are getting into bad habits. But the thing is, your concentration will be on this game, so that you will be on the right path.
Sir, as you have told me that there were no teacher of yours when you started playing cricket. So what lesson you would like to give those youngsters who don't have coaches, you know, they belongs to very backward area, slum areas, they don't even know how to play, how to choose the ball, how to, you know, introduce themselves, especially for the sport. So what message you would like to give to them to grow up in a certain way, and how can they learn in an initiative way? Or you can say in a very process way, what should be the criteria, how they can learn cricket, and then after coaching is the, you know, main role where the coaching will give you that part where you can play for a better manner. So initial stage, and the coaching stage, and then after. See, how the could you is, see all these categories?
The thing is, when we started playing, there was no television at all. So there are two things you can learn by watching some of the cricketers, and then go on talking to some people, and then reading some books or reading some magazines, you can learn a lot. Plus, if you try to contact somebody who has played at a decent level of cricket, go and talk to him, and then learn what I should do, and then you can learn a few things. But watching the television, there are two things. One is, don't try to copy a Virat Kohli or a Rohit Sharma or a Umesh Yadav or somebody. You be what you are. Okay, don't try to copy them, but watch them how they play, and then try to play like what they do, but don't copy their style. That is the advice I would like to give. But if you try to copy them, then you will lose your identity, you will lose your natural ability. So that's what I my advice would be. Watching cricket, you can learn a lot. Talking to somebody, you can learn a lot. And when you practice, you should know what you are doing. Every ball you bowl, you should know what you have to bowl. As a bowler, you have to make the batsman play. What is the length? So that try to improve your intelligence by talking to a lot of people, and then practice. Just practice doesn't make you perfect. Perfect practice makes you perfect. So go and join an academy where some senior cricketers will be there, so that you can learn a few things from them, so that your game will improve a bit. And then go and talk to some people who have played at a Ranji level or somewhere. So you talk to them and learn. See, talking and watching, you can learn a lot of things.
There you are, guys, and I believe you will definitely follow all these advices given by a legendary person. Now, one more thing I would like to confirm from you, sir. In these days, modern cricket is the white ball cricket is very popular, right? So every youngsters want to play in IPL only. As per you, they should go for only IPL, and they should have some different you know, aim to play with, first of all? I mean to say, they should concentrate on a domestic cricket as well. Is that?
See, the thing is, when you are young, you should play all three forms of the game. See, IPL is something everybody wants to play. I've seen, I've been involved in IPL since 2008 onwards. Everybody, see, the IPL is evolving into a very intelligent game. It is not that everybody can hit sixes and fours. So you should know the situation. You should know how to bowl in a particular situation. You should know how to bowl to a particular batsman. As a bowler, this is what you should look at. You should have variations in bowling. So all these things you have to practice. So you should play all forms of the game. It is not only T20 cricket. T20 cricket is very exciting, agreed. Everyone follows because it's a short form. In 3 hours' time, you get a result and all those things, that's fine. But you cannot just play T20 cricket and survive. Even some of the best cricketers like Adam Gilchrist and Glenn McGrath, after they retired from their international career, they played 1 year. The second year, I could see a big drop. Third year, they are out of the IPL teams. Okay?
Fantastic.
So the problem is, you should play a three-day game or a two-day game. You should play 50 overs. You should play a T20. Then only you will differentiate between three forms of the game, and then you will be able to do what is necessary for T20, what is necessary for 50 overs, what is necessary for a two-day or three-day game. So you should play all three forms of the game. It is not that only T20. If you do well in all three, then you can always do well in T20. If you are a good two-day player, you will do well in 50. If you are a good 50 overs player, you will do well in T20. But you need to be very, very smart in T20. That's what does make a ordinary player to a good player. You have to be very smart. You should think that everybody thinks that there is no time in T20, but if you think, there is a lot of time. Lot of time. Okay, you need to bowl. As a bowler, you have to bowl only 4 overs. You should know which are the 4 overs you can bowl, either at the top or at the otherwise you have to bowl in the death. Not everybody can bowl between 7 overs to 16 overs. So you should be able to bowl in all three block of overs. You should be able to bowl at least 1 or 2 overs at the top, 1 over in the middle, and 1 over at the death. So you should be very, very intelligent and smart. Then only you can survive in T20. 50 overs is not like that. You can come back into the game even if you have a first 2 overs, bad overs. Even if you have played 10 balls, you have taken only 2 runs, or 20 balls, you have taken only 5 runs. But next 30 balls, you can quickly get a 40, and then it becomes 40 ball 50. So it is, you have to be intelligent and smart, then you will excel in all three forms of the game.
There you are, guys. One more question. This World Cup is going to be started by 30th of this May, and that will be held in England. How difficult that would be for Team India, sir, as you have been traveling in all over the world, and you knows better about everything. So what strategy Team India should apply to win this World Cup among the all great competitive teams?
India has got a very good team. I think it's one of the best batting side we have. Even the bowlers, Bumrah is excellent, and Chahal and Kuldeep Yadav, they are left arm Chinamen, and then leg spinners. They're going to bowl in the middle overs, so they can cause a lot of worry to foreigners, basically. Plus, we have Shami, and then we have Bhuvneshwar Kumar. I think India has got a very well balanced side, and Dhoni is there to guide the team. He's the most experienced player in the team. I think India has got a very good chance. I would put India at number one to win the league, and then along with England, and then Australia is not too far. These are the three teams I really fancy that they will be in the semi-final lineup. Fourth team could be anybody, West Indies or Pakistan or New Zealand, any of these teams, South Africa. But India, England and Australia, this is the these are the three teams which could be in the semi-final lineup. Because
we
after
have
semi-finals, it is anybody's game.
Oh, exactly. It's a semi-final. This could be anybody's game. That was a big game. But before that, you would have at least 6 to 7 matches to play.
Every team has to play 9 matches.
9 matches. So you would have plenty of matches. So you will be able to know about your strength and weaknesses. So you will get the better adjustment.
I'm sure that India will be in the semi-final lineup.
You were talking about the Kuldeep Yadav, the Chinaman, but as we have seen in KKR, Kuldeep performance wasn't that good as he known for. So do you really think that lack of confidence will make some trouble for him, or he's a champion player, he can get any comeback?
T20 is different because if one over somebody gets hurt, the captain is hesitant to give him another over because depends on what is the total they have scored. Suppose somebody has scored 220 runs, and he can always gamble at giving him one more over because he's basically a wicket-taking bowler. At the same time, he may go for some runs. But in a 50-over game, it's totally different because particularly World Cup is going to play against Australia, England, New Zealand, all these foreigners, they are not comfortable playing left-arm Chinaman. I think he should be definitely a bowler to reckon with in World Cup.
I think we are done with under 16 trials. Now we are ready with the under 19.
He wasn't in the playing 11. 13th time England has Jofra Archer. For the England pace battery, as we have all seen his performance since IPL. So do you really think he is going to repeat the same performance?